Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
A very, very good morning.
A very good morning. God bless you in abundance.
Amen. 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 My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, you're following with Brother Johnson what happened in his life. You finished 2 days. We have come to the third one. Well, brother, my question to you is, when you came out, you were totally poor. You didn't have a house. You didn't have anything. No money,
I had no money to eat food.
No money to eat food.
Yeah.
How did you come out of it? How did you bounce back?
Yeah. What happened was, after my 9 days and all that, I began to go to Chembur and I said to Father Jose, why I'm going to join you and I will serve the Lord. And he said, no, the Bible says in Timothy 5:8, that when a person does not supply for his own household, he's worse than an unbeliever if he doesn't provide. Okay.
Yeah.
So he said, you must go and find a job. So when he said that, I went in search of a job and I did get a job in my own industry.
Wow.
Okay. Now, God gave me a job and with a Gujarati man, and having the technology, that I said to him, I'm not going to work on salary, but I'm going to work on commission and on production. So I told him I will work at night, and during the day I will work at night. So he had no problems as long as the job is done. So his product, which was not being sold, with my technology, it started to get sold.
Praise God.
So daytime I used to be doing God's work. Nighttime I would go and serve there. And what happened was, I learned a scripture, give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, men shall pour into your bosom, with what measure you meet, with the same measure you shall be met, and it is more blessed to give than to receive. Now when I got that scripture, I said, God, I want to put this into check. So when the salary came on the commission, I would never give 10%, I would put 40-50%.
Wow.
Even though I had no money, I wanted to know this kingdom, because I had never experienced this. You know, all your life you have been living in a dirty water and suddenly you get oxygen. What happens? I was crazy, absolutely crazy. And when I began to put that, God just multiplied and multiplied. In 8 months, brother, I was able to start my own business. Now, when Father said this, that you have to go and find a job, my question to him was, if I find a job, how do I serve God?
Yes.
So he said, the workplace is your church. So what you hear over here, you must practice it over there, so that the people recognize you, not by preaching, but by the doing of the word. So that was a good lesson that he gave me, and that's why I began to become selfless and began to practice in the factory. And that's where I got the actual experience of the word of God. So when I planted that first seed, okay, the commission began to multiply, things began to multiply, and in no more time the money began to come back again. But this time it was in the right way, and the very business that I lost, that same business God gave me back, and this time it started to flourish.
Wow.
So what I found is, there are principles that you apply from the kingdom of darkness and the principles you apply from the kingdom of God. So when you are a sower, and the Bible says, do not get tired in doing good, because in due season you will surely reap your harvest. So the harvest is in multiple and the seed is so small. So when I decided that what God had blessed me, I did not use it for myself, for the kingdom, it became my seed. And everything that I used for myself, it became my harvest. So I had a choice whether I keep sowing or keep eating the harvest. So I made a choice that this biblical principle, let me go on sowing. So I began to sow and sow and sow, and I began to see God just began to flourish. And in a matter of time, it just got me out of the poverty, and everything was good. And one thing that I want to share is about the prodigal son. When he came back, the father accepted. When I was in crisis and I had a big amount to pay, I went to mom and I said, if I don't pay, I will be in trouble. She said, don't worry, dad will help you. And my dad came with the money. He gave me the money, but he did not ask the dialogue. What I told him, what you earn in a month, I earn in a day. He just gave me the money and said, how much is the amount? And he just gave me that money. And he just walked out without asking me a single question. That's when I broke down and I began to realize that if my earthly father can do that, how much more the Heavenly Father can do that. So it was about my relationship with my father was always like, you know, I caused problem, and father, my dad with his love wanted to correct me, but I would all the time retaliate, rebellious. But that's when I broke down and I began to realize that my father's love was so God that I got in love with the Heavenly Father. I learned the love of the Heavenly Father through my dad's relationship with me.
Wow.
Praise God.
Praise
and
God.
That's how I came out of poverty. It took about more than 2 years, but it was a good struggle, and I thank God it did not come quickly, because I had to learn the principles in the Bible.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Well, my dear brothers and sisters, you know what it is. You know how to get out of your problem. We are just exploring his life so that you too can apply the same principle in your life. Beautiful things have happened in his life from here onwards. We will talk about it tomorrow again. You have a great day. God bless you all.
So before you go, what you sow is what you reap. So be careful what you sow in your words, in your thinking, in your actions. They are all seeds. They will surely bring in the harvest.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Have a great day. God bless you.
God bless you. God bless you. Praise you in the heavens. Join with the angels. Praising you forever.